Alright, so Oscar the Grouch is here, and I'm actually filming this outside in my backyard because he smells. He smells really badly, like cigarette smoke, so y'all are just gonna have to see my weed-covered back porch. Sorry about that, I just haven't had time to pick weeds up or anything. All three boys are daisy-chained together. I think I plugged everything in right. So I've got Big Bird plugged into Cookie Monster on Satellite Jack B. And then I've got Satellite Jack A from Cookie Monster hooked up to Satellite Jack A on Oscar. Now, something about Oscar that I've noticed, that's supposed to click off and on, and it doesn't click, so that's a bad sign, but I'm gonna go ahead. They all have batteries, so I'm gonna go ahead and pop a tape in Big Bird and see what happens.
And maybe pick some berries. We're glowing like we're knowing that we're going on a picnic. A picnic, going on a picnic. Today,
nothing's going happening.
A picnic. A picnic, let's be on our way.
Oh, wait. Sound's coming from
Hi
Cookie
there.
Monster.
This is Big Bird. Gee, I'm sure glad you're here, because I want to tell you a story about a very special picnic that I had with my friends.
Before we begin,
I have to tell you about a special sound.
Okay, I don't know if y'all can tell
when
this or not.
This sound,
but the sound is actually
book.
Only coming out wanna of Cookie Monster
again?
Right now.
Okay. Are you ready for the story?
No, Big Bird, I'm not ready.
Turn to the first page in your book.
I don't have my book, Big Bird. What are you doing?
All of this for everyone else. And I have cherries and apples
okay.
and potato chips.
Cookie was talking a second ago.
Uh-oh. I looked all around, but I couldn't see my picnic basket anywhere.
So, this is interesting. Cookie Monster would not turn on without the, without the cord in Satellite Jack B. When I plugged it into Satellite Jack A, nothing would happen. Oscar continues to do nothing.
I still have the lemonade. I spent 2 whole days squeezing lemons with my snuffle so that we could all have homemade lemonade.
Me love lemonade, Snuffy. It's really delicious,
Cookie said. But then we saw what had happened. There was the jug sitting in the middle of a big yellow sticky puddle.
His eyes are supposed to...
It looks like your jug has a leak. Oscar laughed.
I'm gonna try something. I'm gonna try just plugging Oscar into Big Bird and leaving Cookie Monster off for a second. So the first thing to look at was the volume wheel, since it's obviously not working as intended, and I was hoping that was the only issue. I couldn't get any good pictures of Oscar's volume wheel, unfortunately, but it's basically the same as the one on Teddy Ruxpin, so I'll use this spare one I have here as an example. So you see here, when it's in the off position, this little metal piece is pushed out and it's not touching anything. And when you spin the wheel, it snaps into place and then the two metal pieces touch. What happened with Oscar was this little metal piece was bent, and it was bent in such a way that the circuit between the two pieces couldn't be completed because they weren't touching like they were supposed to. I was able to confirm this by using a small piece of metal to manually complete the circuit. When I did this, Oscar beeped. I was able to bend this piece back into its intended shape and also get the dirt out of the spring. It still takes a bit of force to turn off, but at least Oscar will now turn on and off like he's supposed to. The next step was to take him apart and inspect the motors for any additional damage. Disassembling Oscar was shockingly easy. His trash can is basically a shell, so all I had to do was remove the screws and push him down through the bottom of the can. If there's anyone watching this video who's planning on taking apart an Oscar for repairs, I'll mention one thing real quick. Don't remove all the screws on the bottom at the same time. There are some that are inset pretty deep inside the plastic, and others that are smaller and more shallow. The large, deeper screws actually connect the trash can to the base, so all you need to do is remove those first. The smaller, shallower screws connect the battery pack in the base of the can to Oscar directly. So make sure you remove those once he's outside of the can, or you'll risk damaging the wiring connecting Oscar to his battery pack. Just giving you a heads up. So here's some quick shots I took of the base of the can with the battery pack and Oscar's motherboard. Here's also a quick look at the satellite jacks and the volume wheel. The main thing inside Oscar's body is this large motor. I wasn't sure what sort of motor to expect, but the way they designed this is actually pretty interesting. I should note that Oscar is incredibly lightweight, with his top half being mostly hollow, save for one little motor that makes his mouth move, and this large toothed rod that sticks down and fits into a slot on the actual motor. Other than that, like I said, he's hollow on the inside, so not a lot of strain on the motor, which is nice. The motor has a large gear that slots into the teeth of the rod, and that's what makes Oscar raise and lower out of his trash can. So with this in mind, I plugged Oscar into Big Bird and turned them both on, and this happened.
Oh my.
So Oscar was a little confused. He would go up, but not back down. So I took him off the motor again and looked everything over. Inside, I couldn't see anything wrong with the motor itself. No belts were broken on the inside, and all the teeth on the gear seemed fine, so why was he only moving upward? My first suspicion was there was something going on with the motherboard, but then I noticed something funny on the front of the motor. So the motors on a Teddy Ruxpin are very complicated in how they're able to detect what position they're in and adjust accordingly. The motors on these Ideal toys aren't like that. For the mouth, as an example, the motors have two positions, open and closed. So if a kid opens Big Bird's mouth or eyes, it won't really affect the motor because it'll just go to the open position and nothing will happen, and then it'll go back to closed and the mouth will close again. But with Oscar, if he's down inside the can and a child yanks him out, and then the motor kicks in telling him to raise out of the can, he'd just go flying upward, which is exactly what happened here. So they needed a way for the motor to be able to know when Oscar was all the way up or all the way down so it could adjust accordingly. I forgot to get a good picture of it, but there are actually two bumps on the rod that go down inside the motor. Those bumps make this little plastic piece here move up and down, which trigger these micro switches. When the bottom switch is pressed, the motor knows to stop making Oscar move downward. And when the top switch is pressed, it knows to stop making Oscar go upward. It's clearly not completely foolproof, though. The image the seller had on Oscar's listing showed him raised up completely out of the trash can, but when he arrived, he had been pushed down. I'm not really blaming the seller's ignorance for this, but I suspect that when Oscar got pushed downward, it bumped this piece out of position, and the switches weren't getting pressed like they should. So I reset everything, put Oscar back together, and turned him on again.
He wanted to get it fixed before the party. There were so many busy people in my neighborhood that day, and it seemed as if everyone was getting ready to miss stuff on his birthday party. everybody started grumbling. Everybody but Oscar, that is. Oscar said, "This is great. The start of a truly terrible day. Oh, boy." "We can play some ball while we wait," Grover said. After a while, the rain stopped. We all looked out the windows at Oscar. Oscar was busy making mud pies. "How yucky," I said. "It sure is yucky. Yucky and terrific. Don't knock it if you haven't tried it, Turkey," Oscar answered. Oscar seemed to be having such a good time that Cookie climbed off the bus and joined him.
"He right,"
Cookie said.
"Me not like to eat these pies, but they fun to make."
And soon we were all in the mud, making mud pies. The rain didn't wash our fun away. We remained the best of friends. We'll go home with happy thoughts today. That's how our story ends. With a very special picnic. A picnic, a very special picnic. Today, a different kind of picnic. The best kind of picnic. With such good friends who know the way. To have a very special picnic. Any old day.